Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to SSN Canada's continued coverage of Achilles is too late in getting to it, and it will be Stubbart. Only as far as Battistella. Battistella out to Nijnkamp. Nijnkamp tries to drive it into the edge 18-yard box. Offside to Ravens in behind the defence of the Nipissing Lakers. So a bright start by Carleton here inside these first 10-15 minutes. A couple of really good chances down that right-hand side. Brianna D'Souza has been well involved here, a lot more than she was yesterday. When she did get the service yesterday afternoon against Laurentian, she was always a threat, always a danger. And she will have to get that service this afternoon to provide decent balls, decent support into the two strikers. Kayla Wood now to her opposite number, number 19, Aramba. And it's now out with Ingwefusi. Ingwefusi looking for Lavecchia down that left-hand side. She checks back in, looks to side to go across to the right-hand side. Nealon cuts in front of the defender. A good... good play there, I believe, by Cidio. No, that was number 11, sorry. Ashley Poirier. And offside once again against Nipissing. We're still scoreless here this afternoon. Carleton 0, Nipissing 0. OUA East women's soccer action here on SSN Canada. Valerie Hamilton drives the ball up to Lavecchia. It breaks to Nijnkamp. Nijnkamp looking wide now for Ingwefusi. Ingwefusi looking for an early ball into the 18-yard box. It's a good ball. It's in behind the defence. Nealon with a great chance. He takes the first touch, a second touch. Oh, it's off the post. For a second time, the Ravens have hit the woodwork this afternoon. Well, Samantha Bem living a charmed life in the Nipissing goal so far. She's made one good save herself and twice now. The ball has crashed off the woodwork. Once by D'Souza, that second time by Nealon. And it will be a Ravens throw. Sorry, a Ravens free kick. 35 yards from goal. Amanda Ingwefusi is, well, with 37 yards. It's an awful long way going into the wind to try and bother goalkeeper Ben. But there are options inside that 18-yard box. Four of them strung along the edge of the box. The ball's now back to McIntyre. McIntyre chips the ball high. Way too heavy, and goalkeeper Bem with all sorts of time to just pick that up. And start an attack going the other way for Nipissing. Good kick into the Ravens half. Valerie Hamilton challenged by Church. It breaks all the way to the far side. It's a great chance for number 17, Black. Poor ball, though, and it goes back to goalkeeper Bedick. Nealon just tries to flick that on, unable to get it beyond number 17, Black. And Ashley Poirier just knocks it into touch for a Ravens throw, just inside their own half. A click on the heels there, that will be a Nipissing free kick. Church just caught there by McIntyre. A left-footed drive doesn't make the edge of the 18-yard box. And Nealon with a good touch. Tries to play a ball away for Lavecchia. It's in behind the defence. Lavecchia driving into the 18-yard box. Oh, she tries to cut across Ashley Poirier. She just needed to keep going. Keep it on her left foot. And drive into the 18-yard box. The minute she tried to cut back across the two defenders, the defender's job was done. There's a good ball played up over the top for Black to chase after. Black on for Aramba. Aramba trying to get inside ahead of Kayla Wood. Wood doing extremely well again. Just mopping up down that right channel. But it will be a throw-in. For Nipissing. That looked like a bit of a foul throw there. The referee had a look down at the assistant. Well, the referee was 25 yards away. The assistant was 60. And you would expect the referee to make the appropriate call on that one. But it didn't come, and it is a goal kick for the Ravens. So after a four-match winning streak over the last few weeks, the Ravens lost on Wednesday to these Nipissing Lakers and then had a tie yesterday, as we said off the top of the broadcast, with Laurentian. So not faring the best of times against the Northern teams in the last week or so. Nipissing back down here looking to at least pick up a point and help their playoff push. Amy Laidlaw, number 21, is now coming on. Just trying to see who's coming off. Looks like it's number 12, Caitlin Sidio. Amy Laidlaw, midfielder out of Brampton, Ontario. Third year student. Ball's played up to Black. Black's first touch isn't the best, and it breaks now to D'Souza. D'Souza looking for some support down there. McIntyre comes along to help her out. Battistella keeps it going and plays it up into Krista Dermott. A ball played over once again the top of the Ravens. Bedick comes out of her 18-yard box, clears it away. Only as far as central midfield, though. And number 21, Laidlaw's first action. Good defensive play, just cutting in front of Lavecchia. That's a push in the back, and that deal will be a free kick and an opportunity now for Nipissing to launch a ball into the Ravens' 18-yard box. Stubbart will take the free kick. Five white shirts at the edge of the 18-yard box. It's played in the back. It's not the best of balls. It was too close to goalkeeper Bedick, and that ball's now rolled out quickly to Nienkamp. Nienkamp with some space down this left-hand side, trying to play the ball up to Lavecchia. Lavecchia plays a good first-touch ball out to Ingwafusi. Ingwafusi might be a bit hard for Nienkamp. No, she catches up well to it. Nice play by Nienkamp. The ball breaks to Laidlaw, and now it will be with Nipissing down this right-hand side. Stubborn all sorts of time down the right-hand side. Churchill, lovely ball played through for Arama. She's onside. She's got support behind her in Stubbart. And Kayla Wood. Well, Kayla Wood, her touch was a bit heavy, but she does win the throw-in. So a good break down this right-hand side. Aramba, unfortunately, just unable to direct it. Her first touch back towards goal. It will be another throw-in this time for the Ravens. Laidlaw does well. Stubbart wins it, and it's now at the edge of the 18-yard box. And all Kayla Wood can do once again is just put it into touch. Oh, Aramba's gotten away nicely from the defence. Battistella, though, at the edge of the 18-yard box, winning the second ball. It's a poor pass, though, and it goes on. Nice ball to Black. Black trying to play the ball down the left-hand side. D'Souza does well, coming back to help out. Laidlaw knocks it over for Church to get a chance to break into the 18-yard box. Can she get a ball across the face of goal? She can't, but it will be a corner kick. Stubbart going across to that far side. So a nice piece of sustained pressure here in these last 3 or 4 minutes by Nipissing. Both teams searching for this opening goal this afternoon. Stubbart's a good ball to the centre of goal. Excellent goalkeeping by Bedick. Good shout, good safe pair of hands. And she starts quickly the other way. Sam Nealon chasing after it. Support with D'Souza just inside. Just a little bit under 20 minutes gone. Nipissing nil. Carleton with two or three good chances so far in this match. They've hit the woodwork twice. Nienkamp cuts that ball out. It breaks into McIntyre. It's a high ball played once again for Nipissing. Well, this certainly does seem to be a bit of a game plan this afternoon for Nipissing. Try to play the ball over the top for Aramba and possibly Church to sneak in the back of the Ravens' defence. It hasn't worked so well this afternoon in this first period of the first half. Nienkamp drills it down the far side, the left side here. Krista Dermott will try to let... Oh, she's played it now. She's got to... Well, she's put herself in all sorts of trouble unnecessarily. And it will be a corner kick for the Carlton Ravens. Lavecchia ball into the front post area. That will be a free kick. Looks like an injured Nipissing player down on the ground. We're just trying to see her number. Referee says she's okay. Looks like number 11, Ashley Poirier, will have to soldier on. She looks to be all right. A little bit of a limp there on the left foot, the left ankle possibly, as she got kicked trying to clear that last ball from the corner. And it will be Samantha Bem with the clearance. Battistella knocks it right up into there. Lavecchia tries to get on it first. Jodwan can't get it beyond Laidlaw. It's a good ball played up to her arm. A good first touch taking it wide off nine camp, and it goes to Ingmar Fussi. Ingmar Fussi plays it off Aramba, and it will be a Ravens throw. Dermot plays it up high for Church to chase after. Valerie Hamilton gets there first. Good control by Church. Oh, nice play to get away. Tries to drive in a shot there. Easily blocked by Hamilton, and it breaks now for Battistella. Battistella plays it up for Lavecchia. She can't get on the end of it. Poirier just knocks it back into the Ravens' half. Valerie Hamilton will try to do the same the other way. Nienkamp caught, Battistella caught in possession, though. Nienkamp has to cover down this right-hand side. She hasn't done a good job. Aramba, oh, not the best of balls as she tried to play the ball into her striking partner, Church, just inside the 18-yard box. Screwed the ball wide, and it will be a goal kick for the Ravens. Stubber just knocks it into the Ravens half around, but now for Church. Church, good turn. The ball played through down the right-hand channel for Aramba to chase after. She won't catch that. A little bit too heavy from Kimberly Tate in central midfield. So both teams in this 4-4-2 formation. Nipissing actually playing with three and a sweeper just behind them. Carleton with a flat back four. For Coach Alec McNutt here in 2010. Struthers does well to play the ball up to Black in central midfield. Black is caught in possession though by Battistella. It's back to D'Souza, who plays it into McIntyre, trying to find Ingmar Fussi. It breaks now for Nienkamp. Nienkamp to Nealon. Good first touch, good control. The ball now with Battistella, trying to bring Ingmar Fussi into the play on this left wing. It's bouncing around there. That's a good ball. Looks like they're both onside. Nealon and Lavecchia on that far side. The ball just checked up there. Nealon lost possession, and Church plays the ball inside now to Tate. Tate plays a good ball for Aramba. Aramba's got a good chance. She's in behind Valerie Hamilton. Driving inside the 18-yard box. A good chance. Oh, good save by goalkeeper Bedick. Well, terrific work by Aramba there as she broke into the 18-yard box. She was the meat in the sandwich by two Ravens defenders. She kept her head down, kept going. And goalkeeper Bedick, as she's done so often this year, reading the danger, coming out and making the save just inside her own 18-yard box. But a good break by Nipissing. And we did say that was something the Ravens will have to be concerned with all afternoon, is that ball up over the top. Valerie Hamilton and Kayla Wood can't afford to get caught square as they're marking Aramba and Church. Hamilton, Nienkamp. Ingmar Fussi, lots of space down this left-hand side. Good defensive play by Dermot. She does keep it in play. It all goes out for a throw-in for the Ravens instead of a corner. Ingmar Fussi was offside as that ball was played back to her. It's taken short. It now goes to centre midfield. Valerie Hamilton's first there. It's not the best of touches, and it will go into touch for a throw-in for Krista Dermott. Aramba against Hamilton, and once again, Hamilton sticking to Aramba like glue. Dermott plays the ball into Laidlaw. Laidlaw flicks it on. Kayla Woods, a good touch into D'Souza. D'Souza has to release Lavecchia. She's offside right now. She's moved back into an onside position. It's a good ball down that right channel for Lavecchia, trying to drive into the 18-yard box. Once again, she cuts back across two defenders. Sam Nealon, just a weak effort from the 18-yard box. Well, on a couple of occasions, Lavecchia's had a chance to maintain that run. And on both times has opted to cut back across defenders instead of just putting the head down and driving right into the 18-yard box and getting a shot on goal for herself. Battistella does well. Knocks it forward for Nealon. Defenders missed it. Does well a second time. Justine Carlisle. The ball's now with Struthers on that far side. D'Souza cuts it out. Back to D'Souza. Into Battistella. Ah, it's a poor ball. It's easily cut out by Struthers. But the Ravens win it back again. McIntyre trying to switch the ball. I think she mishit that, but it's broken to D'Souza at the edge of the 18-yard box, and it will be black. She can't keep it in play. McIntyre now with the throw-in. 17 minutes remaining here in this scoreless first half between the Ravens and the Lakers. OUA East women's action here this afternoon. Black again looking to play the ball up and over. It breaks to Church. Church has wide open on this far side. Number 9, Stubbart, down the right-hand side. Valerie Hamilton's a slack ball. Laidlaw decides to have a crack from 25 yards. Well wide of goalkeeper Beddick's left-hand post. Looks like there will be a substitution coming in. A second time, number 16, Valaine Confessor. Coming in for number 17, Maddie Black. So Confessor, a first-year student out of Toronto, last team played for was the Markham Lightning. She will now take that position wide on the left for Coach Castiglione. There's another high ball played up over the top. Kayla Wood, well, she didn't judge it as well as she needed to. The goalkeeper, Beddick, doing extremely well, clearing her lines. Accidental handball there. Laidlaw, Jodwan battling hard for it. Tate battling as well. Central midfield, she wins at Laidlaw. The two number 21s colliding there. Battistella comes off with the free kick, and it will be Kayla Wood leaving it for Valerie Hamilton. A ball played. Well, that's a very, very dangerous ball by Valerie Hamilton. There was no need for that at all. Kayla Wood was spared. If you're going to try and play it short and build up from the back, Nienkamp and Kayla Wood were both far better options than that chip there that was easily cut out by Confessor down that left-hand side. McIntyre battling well, not allowing Church a chance to feed Confessor down the left wing, and it will be Struthers being charged with the responsibility to throw the ball into the danger area. Aramba looking for it just around that place. It does go to her. She tries to turn away from Kayla Wood. McIntyre can only head it out for a throw-in once again. ...15 minutes to go here. We have had a few goal-mouth incidents this afternoon. Carleton have hit the woodwork twice, but we're still scoreless here. Lisa Church, well, she looked to be impeded there, and the referee has caught that. Good spot by the official, and it will be a dangerous free kick. Kimberly Tate coming across to take this. Fourth-year student out of Peterborough. And this is a dangerous opportunity. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 white shirts, 7 now inside the 18-yard box. Number 7, Justine Carlisle, looking for the second ball. It's a ball driven into the 6-yard box. It's all the way to the back. Oh, it's a goal! Horrific defending by the Ravens across that 6-yard box. The goalkeeper, Beddick, asking why that ball was allowed to travel all the way back to the middle of the goal. And with 15 minutes remaining on the 30th minute, a goal by number 16, Confessor, as she snuck in at the back post. Brutal defending by the Ravens inside that 18-yard box. And Nipissing have taken a 1-0 lead here this afternoon on a goal by substitute Valen Confessor. She's probably scored a few goals in her time. She wouldn't have scored an easier one than that, to be perfectly honest with you, from about 4 yards out. A wide open net as that ball flashed across the 6-yard box. Goalkeeper Bedick stayed on her line, didn't come for it, expecting her back four or five to clear that away. They didn't do it. And that ball ended up in the back of the net for our first goal this afternoon. Nipissing 1, Carleton 0. The ball now with Battistella. Battistella looking to her right for Nealon. It's a good defensive play by. Well, that ball spun away almost as it hit Confessor. Mishit. It spun back to goalkeeper Bem. And she'll now launch a long ball. Kayla Wood just letting that bounce all the way back to goalkeeper Bedick. So the wind in the favour of Nipissing right now, but the sun right in the eyes of goalkeeper Bem for Nipissing. Pushing the back there by Hamilton. No free kick called. Lavecchia now just inside the Nipissing half. Tries to play over to D'Souza. The ball's headed off by number 10, Struthers. D'Souza trying to get around Carlisle. Plays a good ball to the front of the 6-yard box. Nealon trying to get on the end of that. And it's knocked out by number 11, Poirier, for a corner kick for the Ravens. Yeah, and the coach Castiglione asking why that free kick was not given against Valerie Hamilton in the Ravens' half about 30 seconds ago. Certainly did look like a push in the back as she challenged for that. A ball to the edge 18-yard box. It's not cleared away. It breaks all the way to Nienkamp here at the back. Ingwafusi can't keep it going for it. It's Aramba now breaking down the middle of the park. Battistella's caught in possession. Aramba plays it through. Church just can't get on the end of it. And it will go all the way back to goalkeeper Bedick. A third substitution ready to come in for Nipissing. Number 25, Shannon McLeod. Poirier knocks that high up into there. Does well to get it. Kayla Wood, though, nips in front of Aramba. Battistella just trying... Lavecchia just trying to knock it forward for Ingwafusi to chase after. Couldn't do so. And again, goalkeeper Bem has a chance to clear her lines. Good strong kick into the Ravens half. Kayla Wood can only put it as far as Tate. Dermot, good ball to Aramba. Good chance for Church to chase after it again. Kayla Wood slides in. Knocks it out wide. Nienkamp will knock it out for the throw-in. Saves the corner. And we have a substitution now. That one we talked about coming in. Number 25, Shannon McLeod. Couple for the Ravens. Number 9, Alexandria Druggett. And number 22, Melissa Baines. Coming in. So both teams now have made 3 substitutions each. And it is number 19, Nicole Aramba. The rookie out of Bradford coming out. She's had a lively first half. She's caused the 2 central defenders of the Ravens some bother here this afternoon. And number 25, McLeod, has gone in as a striker. Well, once again, Church, a lovely little flick for her striking partner, but I think it was Church was in an offside position as she came back into play. Being active, she was called offside. Baines has gone in up front, replacing Nealon. And Druggett has taken over in central midfield from Diane Jodwin. Sheila Lavecchia, well, that's a slack ball. Hamilton for Stubbart. Stubbart plays a heavy ball into the 18-yard box. Goalkeeper Bedick will let that run. Diane driven into the Nipissing half. Poirier does well just to knock it back into Church. Church trying to turn, play the ball down the left-hand side, but once again, the Ravens defence quickly on her. Dermot knocks a high ball. Kayla Wood can only play it as far wide as the goal scorer, Confessor, on that left-hand side. And again, the ball just too heavy. Goalkeeper Bedick will look to play it once again into the Lakers' half. 8.5 minutes to go here in this first half. Nipissing 1, Carleton 0 on a 30th minute goal by substitute Valen Confessor. On a poor defensive play by the Ravens on a free kick. It was always going to be dangerous. The Ravens didn't cover as the ball was whipped across the 6-yard box. And there was Confessor at the back post to gladly put the ball into the back of the net. Dermot caught in possession by Lavecchia. Carlisle, though, gets the ball played up into the Ravens' half. It's a good ball played by Wood for Baines. Baines cuts inside on Poirier. She's got one on three. A good effort. The ball's gone out of play. Goalkeeper Bem looked as if she'd kept that in play on the save. A good effort by Baines. May have been going wide anyway, but Bem had to make the save. And it will be another corner kick for the Ravens. Erica Battistella going across to play that in right. Footed out swinger. It's a good ball to the edge of the 6-yard box. Kayla Woods got up there. Druggett's up as well. Druggett can't direct it back into the danger area. And Poirier will just let that run into touch. A good corner kick that time by Battistella. High to the edge of the 6-yard box. Unfortunately, Kayla Wood just couldn't direct it on target and drug it on the follow-up header. Could only put it wide for a goal kick for Nipissing. Oh, drug it's a poor ball. Fortunate, though, Nipissing can't capitalise on that. Hamilton to Inglefussy. Inglefussy to Nienkamp. Lavecchia, good first touch. Tries to turn away from Dermot, she does. Druggett caught in possession once again. Well, that's twice in the space of 30 seconds. Possession's been conceded by Druggett in midfield. Wood to Inglefussy. Inglefussy caught in possession, though. Good play by Laidlaw. A good ball to McLeod. McLeod into Church. Church, a good turn away from Kayla Wood. McIntyre has to come across. Can only knock it high into the air. Laidlaw for McLeod. McLeod plays the ball over to the far side. Confessor trying to sneak in at the back. McIntyre did well. Lavecchia now to Inglefussy. Inglefussy, lots of space down this left-hand side. Plays it into Baines. Baines quickly closed down by Carlisle. Plays the ball to the edge 18-yard box. Poirier does well to knock it up to Church. Kayla Wood there's first, though. D'Souza would be offside. The referee deciding to call that. As that ball was played back in by the Ravens defender. 5.5 minutes to go here. OUA East Women's Soccer action on SSN Canada. Nipissing with a 1-0 lead here this afternoon. Well, a free kick given against Church there for just backing in a little bit, sticking the hip out. And Kayla Wood will get a chance to drive it up to Baines or Lavecchia. No, decides to play it short for McIntyre back to Wood. Well, I mean, that's twice now the Ravens have been guilty of just trying to be too cute, too fancy. One touch play, one touch possession, and it's cost them. And we saw it earlier on a free kick by Valerie Hamilton. And we saw it there again. And there's a chance now for McLeod against Hamilton. And finally Hamilton plays it off of McLeod. It looked like it was going to have to be a corner kick there. But Hamilton did well to win the goal kick. Well, Lisa Church, as we said, with those 7 goals in the OUA East, that's a terrific return for any striker at any level, and especially when you're in a division like the OUA East, where it's a lot of quality teams, certainly at the top of the division. And here's a break for England. Fussy now down the left-hand side. Oh, it's a good defensive play by Poirier. The ball needed to be released a little bit early, though, for Baines, who'd made a good run down the left channel. McLeod now battling hard. Does well, plays the ball to Church. Church trying to turn away from Caleb Wood. It's a little bit too heavy, though, and the ball came out here for Stubbart. So those 7 goals by Church, when you're up against teams like Ottawa, Toronto and Queens, and then Carleton, Laurentian and Ryerson, all quality teams that are tough to score against. 7 goals is an excellent tally for one of your main strikers. And that's obviously what's keeping Nipissing in the playoff hunt here in 2010. Goalkeeper Bem decided to stay. Poirier goes to ground. She was lucky she didn't make contact there with Baines. Well, Baines sort of quit on the play. She gave up. Looked to the referee for the free kick. Good read by Nienkamp. Plays the ball now into Baines. It's not the best of balls, and it breaks to central midfield for McIntyre. She's caught in possession. Does get the free kick, though. Inside 3 minutes here in this first half. Carlton 0, Nipissing 1. Coach Al McNutt trying to rally his troops for one final push in this first half. Hamilton plays the ball up to Baines at the edge of 18-yard box. Good control. Plays a nice flick out to Inglefuss. Inglefuss looking for support. Cuts back inside. It goes to Druggett. Druggett plays it wide all the way to McIntyre. McIntyre, well, that's an easy ball for goalkeeper Bem to take safely into her hands. Hit far too heavily by McIntyre. And a promising attack for the Ravens broke down at a crucial time. Confessor now inside to Tate. Tate looking for Dermot on this far side. Dermot looking to play the ball down. Oh, McLeod's offside. Number 9 here, Stephanie Stubbart, also offside. The referee acknowledging the flag and allowing play to continue. Well, that's a handball. That's a handball. The whistle did not go. You cannot play to the flag. You have to play to the whistle. And goalkeeper Beddick and the defender Hamilton completely mixed up between the two of them there. Well, I don't understand. That's a terrible, terrible call. I don't know what's going on here. I have no idea what's going on here. Oh, that's shocking. That really is shocking. You cannot reverse that call after you've made the correct call on the field of play. It was a handball. The ref did not call for an offside. And because the ball was picked up, you penalised Nipissing. Well, that's shocking. I'm sorry, folks, but that's a terrible decision by the official and the assistant. He'd already made the right call in my mind. And for some unknown reason, he decided to make a change. That was horrible. Absolutely horrible decision by the referee. And that could have cost Nipissing because they were pushing up to take the free kick and they may have been caught out. Very, very poor decision by the officials. The ball comes off of Kayla Wood. Goes into the far corner for a Nipissing throw-in. As we're into injury time here in this first half. Well, if you're coach Vito Castiglione, you have to be very, very angry at that last call. Laidlaw inside the 18-yard box. It breaks off a Church. And it will be D'Souza just knocking it out into play. Ball's knocked up for Church. She's onside. A good ball whipped into the 18-yard box. A good chance for Laidlaw, and it comes to the back post. Stubbart goes up to head it. She wins it again on the second attempt. A good chance for Nipissing. Oh, and McLeod just takes it off of Church, who was in a far better position to possibly get a volley away inside that 18-yard box. Well, on that last play, the controversial one a few minutes ago, there definitely was an offside. But the referee put his thumb up to the assistant referee to allow play to continue because Carlton had possession. And then he called it back. And here's now Ingmar Fushi with a break down the left-hand side. Good defensive play by Stubbart. Wonderful job by Nipissing working together. Carlisle gets it knocked high into central midfield, and that will be the end of the first 45 minutes. A goal on the 30th minute by Valen Confessor has given us a 1-0 lead here this afternoon for the Nipissing Lakers. And as we suspected, it will be a visit by the Nipissing coach. Just asking the referee for clarification on that last catalogue of errors on that call there. There's no point in shrugging your shoulders, Mr. Referee. You made the right call in allowing play to continue, and then for some unknown reason, you called the play back, which was 100% incorrect. So as it is, it's 45 minutes in the books. And Nipissing Lakers with a 1-0 lead here at halftime on the Carlton Ravens. Stay tuned. Second half action coming up very shortly. And welcome back to second half action here this afternoon on SSNCanada.ca. My name's Gordon Smith. The Nipissing Lakers with a 1-0 lead over the host Carleton Ravens this afternoon. OUA East women's soccer action. And Nipissing hold on for three very valuable points this afternoon. It will be almost a guarantee that they will wrap up that final playoff spot in the OUA East. It may mean a trip to Toronto a week on Wednesday, but that's what it's all about right now, is just getting into the playoffs, and who knows what can happen once you are in that sudden death format in the playoffs. Doesn't look to be any substitutions for either team here in this second half. Baines and Lavecchia staying on as the two strikers for the Ravens, McLeod and Church. The opposite two for Nipissing. It's now back to Tate. Tate plays it out wide. D'Souza gets there first though. And breaks though for the Ravens inside their own half. Ball on the far side now with Nienkamp. It's a poor ball once again, and McLeod quickly trying to turn on it. Valerie Hamilton using all her strength, does well. Plays it for Nienkamp, and again another slack ball. Laidlaw's quickly on that. McLeod being pushed from the back. Well, no call coming in again. It's a couple. McLeod feels as if she's been impeded once or twice in that first half as well. No call coming her way, and the ball's bounced over. McIntyre, confessor, can't get there first. Church just tries to keep it alive for Nipissing, and it goes now for McLeod. McLeod coming back from an offside position. And McLeod once again thought that was finally the referee had given her a free kick. And unfortunately, she was called for the offside. Obviously likes the physical side of the game, not afraid to get stuck in, and that's always nice for a striking partner like Church, who will do the finesse work and put the ball in the back of the net when you've got a striker that's willing to run all day and go up against tough defenders. It sure makes your job easier as a striker when you've got a partner like that. So started off with number 19, Nicole Aromba, up alongside Church, and we now have Shannon McLeod out of Port Dover, Ontario, striking this afternoon for head coach Vito Castiglione as his Lakers nurse a 1-0 lead here this afternoon over the Ravens. The ball's flicked on now all the way back to Kayla Wood. Kayla Wood knocks it up for Baines to chase after. Baines is onside, but it will run into touch. So a fairly mild afternoon here in Ottawa. It's still windy. You can see the wind now well and truly in favour of the Ravens left to right. But the sun is also right in the eyes of Rachel Beddick, and as she looks up the park at the action taking place, she has her right hand over her eyes to try and protect her vision from the sun. So that may be an issue if there's high balls pumped in from central midfield or wide left positions, as Beddick's looking right into the sun on that play. Dermott with the throw-in. Flicked on nicely by Tate, but is the Ravens in possession? Valerie Hamilton trying to switch the play over to Lavecchia. It's cut out by Struthers. Struthers taken out late there by Battistella. And Ashley Poirier, second year student out of Thunder Bay, with the free kick. The ball out wide now on that far side to Dermott. Dermott plays a good ball for McLeod to chase after down the right flank. Nienkamp does well though, plays a nice ball up to Ingwefusi. Her first touch brings it under control. She plays it all the way back to Hamilton, and Hamilton's a slack ball once again to Tate in centre midfield. There's a great chance here for Church down the middle. A left-footed shot from about 25 yards trying to catch Beddick off guard. Didn't catch it cleanly. And that sailed well high over the goal. But another slack ball by the Ravens defence into midfield, allowing Nipissing to transition from defence into attack. And unfortunately for Nipissing at that occasion, Church just not able to add to her tally of seven here in 2010. The ball played over now for Ingwer Fussy on that far side. She'll do very well to catch up with it. She can't. And it will be left for Krista Dermott. Bachelor of Science student, third year out of Milton, Ontario. Played for the Lakers for 3 years. Kayla Wood again trying to bring Baines into the play. It's a good run down the channel for Baines. Poirier does well though, coming across and just knocking the ball into touch once again. And Mafusi will take this down the left. Looking for a red shirt. Baines now has to come across from her central position. It's a ball played now into Church. Church plays a good ball now for McLeod to chase after. McLeod trying to get away from Hamilton. Cuts inside, plays a ball. Oh, it's not the best of balls. It's behind Confessor. I think McLeod just needed to put her head down and keep going. She may have gotten in the back of Valerie Hamilton. The ball's put high up into there. Carlisle now into Tate. Tate can only put it as far as Ingwer Fussy, and she launches it right into the heart of the centre circle. A good ball played that way to D'Souza now. D'Souza trying to turn away. She's caught from behind though by Struthers, and it will be a Ravens free kick. D'Souza seems to be limping a little bit. And she comes across for that ball. McIntyre will leave the free kick for Kayla Wood just inside their own half. And again, a short ball played to McIntyre. Well, that... well, at some point, you just have to give up and just keep launching high balls, because you've now tried three times. The last three times you've had free kicks, you've just surrendered possession right back because you've been unable to maintain possession on the short free kicks. You know, same again. You had another one there. You advance 5 yards and then you concede the ball back to Nipissing once again. Nipissing doing a good job. McLeod well offside as she continued her run about 3 or 4 yards off. And right now, there's definitely a frustration level, even though she's leading 1-0 for Coach Castiglione and his assistant coaches, David Bitonte, Dan Capitanchuk, and Carlo De Bueno. Just starting to wonder about what game this referee's watching, because there has been a few calls that have gone against her. It's a lovely ball to Ingwer Fussy. Oh, she lets it run across her body. She can catch up with it. She's got a second chance, though. Can she put it into the 18-yard box? A great chance. Oh, it's a goal! Well, it looked like the first chance she had, she let it run too far. When she finally did get a one-on-one, she got beyond the defender. No white shirt was there to support and back up the defender all by herself. And she whipped a ball across the face of goal, beyond the goalkeeper. And 8 minutes into this second half, the Carlton Ravens have tied it up once again. It's their star player of the moment, Amanda Ingwer Fussy, with a lovely curling right-footed shot into the bottom right-hand corner, and it's now Carlton 1, Nipissing 1. Baines now turning away from Stubbart, back to goal scorer Ingwer Fussy. Ingwer Fussy drives the ball to the back post. Lavecchia's offside. About a half a yard offside as that ball was driven across by Ingwer Fussy. Absolute pinpoint accuracy by Amanda Ingwer Fussy, picking out Lavecchia at the back post. But unfortunately for the Ravens and coach Alec McNutt, just a half a step offside. Bem's clearance is cut out by the Ravens. It will be Confessor knocking it forward for Church. Church gets a second chance at it. She can't keep it in play. Oh, yes, she can. And it goes to Confessor. McLeod and McIntyre both battling for it. McIntyre appeared to come out. She's not paying attention off. Well, a throw-in has been given to... Well, a free kick's been given. Well, that's... another strange one there. It just looked like both players were just trying to battle for the ball. It's a slight ball to Ingwer Fussy. It's cut out by Stubbart. Hamilton play it up to Lavecchia. Lavecchia, good first touch, plays the ball into McIntyre. McIntyre, not the best of balls, taking with Fusi. And she'll just let that run into touch for a throw-in once again for Nipissing. Well, McLeod just has Nijnkamp come right through the back of her for a free kick right at centre midfield. And it will be Krista Dermott with the free kick. Carlisle knocks it up for McLeod. Hamilton gets the head on it first. Unfortunately, Laidlaw can't get on the end of it, but it's still bouncing around the Ravens' defensive third. Well, a bit of a collision there between Stirlers and Carlisle, and the ball breaks now into central midfield for Battistella. Good win by her, and the ball's all the way back to goalkeeper Bedick. And she plays the ball up to central midfield. Tate gets beyond her, but she does get a second bite at the cherry. Kayla Wood to McIntyre. Oh, dear, oh dear. Well, I mean, you just have to compose yourself and just settle down a little bit, because in those areas, you can't afford to be giving the ball away. And it's two or three times it has happened. And McIntyre's been very fortunate that Nipissing haven't been able to quickly transition into attack. The ball's now with Nijnkamp. Carlisle at the edge, 18 yard box, can only flick it to Confessor. Confessor does well to hook it out. Tate now to Laidlaw. Laidlaw looking for some support. It's Church out on that far side now to Stubbart. The ball's played in behind McLeod. Two Ravens strikers caught offside there. Have to let the ball run. I don't think they were going to catch up to it anyway. 12 minutes gone here in the second half. Carleton with an early goal. 8 minutes into the second half has tied things up here this afternoon. Shella Vecchia plays the ball down for D'Souza. It's way too heavy. D'Souza in a month of Sundays would never catch that. And it will be a goal kick. Nipissing looking to make a change once again. On the goal kick, Maddie Clark coming back in. She looks like she's replacing number 9, Stephanie Stubbart. So Black will go, started off wide on the left, will now go wide on the right as Stubbart makes way. When the ball getting caught up in the wind there from the kick out by Bem. Tate caught in possession though by Battistella. Shella Vecchia now trying to get something going for the Ravens. Cuts inside Poirier. Good defensive play. McIntyre, well, another slack ball by the fullback. Does well, though, on the second attempt to get back and cuts it out. But too much possession being surrendered by the Ravens. Nipissing not doing much better themselves, unfortunately. And the game's kind of bogged down a little bit here in central midfield. As at 1-1, the Ravens looking to take more than just 2 points out of this weekend. The weekend when they were looking at possibly maximum points. Could only tie yesterday. And it looks now that McIntyre has come off. McLeod is onside, a great chance. Good first touch, you set a shot up, here it is. Oh, great save by the goalkeeper. It was a central shot, she should have gone to one of the bottom corners. It was a good break, a terrific run into the 18-yard box, but the shot was right at goalkeeper Bedick. And in the end, an easy save to make. That substitution, Diane Jodwan, has come in for number 14, Alexandria McIntyre. Will try and, I believe D'Souza will have moved back to right back. The ball whipped into the 6-yard box. Oh, what a save! What a terrific save by Bedick. She reacted to that so quickly. A wonderful head. There was a couple of Nipissing players that challenged for that. I couldn't see which one got their final contact, but an absolutely terrific reaction save by goalkeeper Bedick. She threw herself to the left. Wonderful goalkeeping. Twice in the space of about a minute, goalkeeper Bedick keeps the Ravens at 1-1 this afternoon. Lavecchia. Lovely ball played down for Jodwan. Jodwan's playing on this wide right position now. She won't catch up to it. And as we suggested, Brianna D'Souza has moved back to the right back spot. So a back four now of D'Souza, Wood, Hamilton and Nienkamp. Both fullbacks have been replaced. That started the game for the Ravens. Tutton came off injured. McIntyre in a tactical move by coach Alec McNutt. Druggett wins ahead for Baines. Baines got a chance to chase after this. Goalkeeper Bem does well coming out. Well, a bit of a kick out there by Baines at Poirier there as the two of them are going back for that ball. Not spotted by the official. Nienkamp does well to win it. The ball breaks now though. To Nipissing. Laidlaw getting tugged back by Druggett and it will be a free kick for Ashley Poirier. And the Ravens substitutes being asked to warm up. Five of them head off to the right behind the Nipissing goal. Poirier, good ball played up to McLeod. McLeod trying to bring it under control. The foot is high. And it will be a chance for the Ravens to release the pressure. They've been under a little bit for the last 2 or 3 minutes. D'Souza. Terrible ball. You can see what the intent was. A good run by Battistella. Unfortunately, Brianna D'Souza just unable to keep that in play. McLeod now trying to break away from D'Souza. D'Souza, terrific work. Cutting off that play. Nice little 1-2. But again, it's too heavy, too cute, too fancy by the Ravens, instead of just taking the safety first approach and getting that ball launched out of the danger area. Laidlaw battling very well. The ball breaks now for Struthers. She can't find a white shot though. Battistella driving forward into the Ravens half. Rides a tackle there, plays it. Oh, tried to play it inside to Jodwan. Couldn't find her, and it will be Brianna D'Souza with the throw in for the Ravens. No, she'll leave it for Diane Jodwin. Laidlaw into touch. Hamilton to Nienkamp. Nienkamp, bit of space down the left-hand side. McLeod's coming across nicely to close down. Baines now just inside the Nipissing half, plays it to Battistella. Battistella plays it, a turn ball through. Oh, Inglefusi coming in at the back post, a great chance. Can she play it square? Oh, Lavecchia comes in and puts the ball in the back of the net. A breakdown once again. Inglefusi came from a very deep position, wasn't offside. And as the ball was played across the 6 yard box, Druggett missed it. Couldn't put it in the net. But Sheila Lavecchia, good striking. 18 minutes gone here in the second half. Lavecchia with her first goal this afternoon has made the score Carleton 2. Nipissing 1, number 7, Kimberly Bilmer now coming on. In place of Battistella, Sam Nealon coming in for goalkeeper Sheila Lavecchia, who has just made this game 2-1 this afternoon. A lovely play once again by Amanda Inglefusi down that left hand side. Inglefusi now being moved into central midfield as Bilmer takes that role out wide. So two very intelligent pieces of play by Amanda Inglefusi this afternoon has turned this match from a 1-0 deficit for the Ravens into a 2-1 lead for them. Poirier up to McLeod. Kayla Wood does well to cut that out. And Ben's now turning away from Carlisle. She can't do so, though. Druggett plays it into Kayla Wood. Kayla Wood, the ball to Sam Nealon. D'Souza does well to hustle for that. Plays the ball down the right-hand channel for Nealon to chase after. Poirier will just let that run into touch, and it will be a Lakers goal kick. Well, disappointing for head coach Castiglione, because at 1-0, his team were full value for the lead, even though the Ravens had hit the woodwork twice in that first half. Nipissing seemed to have things well in hand. And Amanda Ingwafusi, a lovely bit of skill for the first goal. And a lovely bit of improvisation for the second has given the Ravens this 2-1 lead. But McLeod now driving forward. Another great chance. Skins against the 18-yard box. She's nudged off. And that's just outside the 18-yard box. That was very, very close. Another step or two, McLeod would have been inside the box. Again, both Ravens defenders beat for the pace of McLeod this afternoon. And a golden opportunity now for Nipissing. 22 yards from goal. A very good position. Church is there, I believe it's number 17, Tate, that's there as well. Possibly trying to curl us around the outside of the wall. Oh, goalkeeper's missed it altogether, and it's a goal! Goalkeeper Bedick fumbled it there, it was a fairly easy shot for her. And she looks like she's injured as well. She may have taken a knock there. But number 25, Shannon McLeod, was first and quickest to react. And with 24 minutes to go here in this second half, on the 66th minute, Shannon McLeod has tied this match up here this afternoon at 2-2. Goalkeeper McNutt's just checking with goalkeeper, sorry, Coach McNutt's just checking with goalkeeper Berwick to make sure she's okay. Well, the shot was hit with a tremendous amount of power. It was right at goalkeeper Berwick. She may have been surprised at how quickly the ball did reach her. And unfortunately, she fumbled the ball. And McLeod, there was two white shirts there, quickest to react. And McLeod got the final touch to put the ball over the line. And once again, we are now tied, this time 2-2, midway through the second half. A good match here this afternoon for you here on SSNCanada.ca. OUA East Women's Soccer action. Nipissing have just tied this game up. In a game where 3 points would do tremendous help for their hope in clinching a playoff spot in the OUA East here in 2010. The Ravens, well, 2 points dropped yesterday against Laurentian. Are they looking at 2 points being dropped again here this afternoon to Nipissing? That ball will run all the way across the goal line. Rachel Berwick picking that up. Throws a good ball out wide to Brianna D'Souza. Lots and lots of space down this right-hand side. Jodwan has to get ahead of her. The two players collided. Well, I mean, again, that has to be a Nipissing throw. Well, that's another strange call by the official here this afternoon. Well, a few calls here this afternoon that Coach Castiglione has not been happy about at all. And you can't really blame him. There has been one or two that has gone against his squad. Brianna D'Souza now, unfortunately. Yeah, the trainer's working on the left leg. It's actually the right leg that she's hurting. The ball's thrown to Druggett now. Good chance now for Laidlaw to play it through. Valerie Hamilton does well to cut it off, looking to play a high ball up over the top for Nealon to chase after. Goalkeeper Bem came for it, then she stopped, leaves it for Poirier to deal with. And Poirier will safely marshal that out for a goal kick for the Lakers. Take two. Aromba, who's come back in. A good ball played out wide. The McLeod trying to go through. She is onside. Another good chance inside the 18-yard box. Kayla Wood. Terrific defensive play once again. It looked like it was Church, I believe, down the middle there, was trying to break away from Kayla Wood. Wood went to ground, stuck her foot out. Terrific defensive play. Inside that 18-yard box, you always have to be careful when you do go to ground there that you're not taking the man out or the player out. And in this case, Kayla Wood, terrific job of putting that ball out for a corner kick, but it's still danger for the Carlton Ravens. It's a good ball again to the 6-yard box. Goalkeeper Bedick, excellent goalkeeping, coming out, making that ball hers. A little bit unlucky on that second goal. Looked like she had it well under control, but unfortunately spilled it at the last. And now Justine Carlisle has gone down with what appears to be a bit of a knock to the head. We're not sure. She's okay. Up on her feet. Poirier will now try to find Church or Aromba just up and around that 18-yard box. And the ball just given back to the Ravens. Fair play. Now Ingafusi, who's come all the way out now to this right-hand side, looking for Baines ahead of her. Cuts inside. Confessor tries to close her off. It's a bit heavy though, and it will go behind though for a corner kick for Carlton. 19 minutes remaining here in the second half. A 2-2 scoreline. An entertaining match this afternoon. As both Nipissing and Carlton seek these 3 points that would push them up the OUA East standings. Goalkeeper Bem, no challenge at all, easily. Two hands on that. Bilmer down that far side, it comes off of Bilmer. Dear, oh dear, that's another call missed altogether. It came off of Bilmer. Bilmer herself was ready for a Nipissing throw-in. Well, the officials, unfortunately, are missing a good match here this afternoon because there's just been far too many calls that have been going the wrong way, unfortunately. And in a lot of cases, they've been going against Nipissing, so they'll be a bit worried that they're not getting, never mind the break of the ball, they're not getting the calls, the 50-50 calls and the calls that should be getting made. Ingmar Fussy now in the 18-yard box. Plays the ball to the back post. A great chance. Baines at the back. Can't bring the ball under control. It bounces off. Her first touch was poor. And it will be a goal kick once again for Nipissing. And the sad part for a lot of these calls is that the officials are only 15 yards away. I think that's what's more frustrating for the Nipissing coach, is that you're actually seeing it, you're looking at the action, and yet you're still making the wrong call. So, not the best of afternoons at the office for the officials here today. Poirier lets that run, goalkeeper Bem again. Safe pair of hands on it. Baines come back from an offside position. It will be Nipissing looking to make another substitution here. Stephanie Stubbart will come back onto the field of play at the next chance. Poirier out wide now to Dermott. Carlisle plays the ball up for Aromba to chase after. The ball breaks for Battistella. It's a poor ball. Dermott just as poor a ball, and it goes to Ingwafusi. Ingwafusi now up and over for Nealon to chase after against Struthers. Can she get beyond her? Two number 10s going head to head. Good defensive play by Struthers, putting the left foot out there, knocking the ball into touch. But it will be a corner kick for the Ravens. Six red shirts in and around that 18-yard box. Nealon with the corner. Once again, goalkeeper Bem, no challenge at all. Our job's been fairly easy on these set plays this afternoon, as the Ravens have struggled to make it difficult for her. It's a good ball played for Ingmafusi. Ingmafusi now in behind Struthers. Goalkeeper's came. She's in no man's land. Oh, terrific goal. What a wonderful goal by Amanda Ingmafusi. The goalkeeper made two or three steps towards the ball, decided to stay, and was absolutely caught out by Amanda Ingmafusi. 30 minutes gone here in this second half, and the Ravens have taken a 3-2 lead on the second goal this afternoon by Amanda Ingmafusi. Two substitutes coming on now. Aromba coming off, Confessor coming off, number 9 Stubbart and number 25 McLeod coming back on. So a terrific match here this afternoon. Carleton 3, Nipissing 2. Sheila LaVecchia looks like she'll be coming on for the final 15 minutes here of this match. But an absolutely exquisite chip by Amanda Ingmafusi. Terrific vision to see the goalkeeper off the line. And a wonderful chip into the back of the net for 3-2 this afternoon. I don't think there's much doubt at all right now who the player of the game is, having scored two goals and set up the third for the Ravens this afternoon. Amanda Ingmafusi has had an outstanding performance in a red shirt for Carleton today. Nealon back to Nienkamp. Nienkamp trying to get it down to Bilmer. Dermott does well, and Laidlaw tries to break away. A free kick has been given for the foul by Bilmer. Nipissing play it short. Poirier now trying to play the ball up front for the Lakers. The ball's now with Poirier. Poirier charged down by Nealon. Plays out wide for Dermott. Back to Poirier. Poirier trying to bring Church into the play. Well, unfortunately, Lisa Church this afternoon has had a fairly quiet second half. Was involved in the first half for Nipissing, but unfortunately in this second period just hasn't been getting the service. It's a handball. Dear, oh dear. I mean, Hamilton actually stuck the right arm out there as that ball came across. Oh dear. Well, an absolute shocker this afternoon for the officials. Valerie Hamilton, as that ball came across, she actually appeared to put her right arm out, and it definitely caught her elbow as it came into the 18-yard box. Carlisle now caught from behind by Nealon, in a free kick given for the Ravens. Dermott plays the ball up to Church. Church not there. Kayla Wood does well to get in front of her. The ball's played up now for McLeod to chase after. McLeod will be offside as she becomes active in that play. And Brianna D'Souza, it's a free kick, will not be able to come in as a substitute. 12 minutes remaining here in this second half. Carleton with a 3-2 lead this afternoon on the Nipissing Lakers. Nipissing battling extremely hard, trying to get something out of this match this afternoon. They took a lead 1-0. They fell behind 2-1. They tied it up and have now fell behind 3-2. It's a 5-on-3 break here. Once again, Ingmafusi down the right-hand side. 1-on-1 against Struthers. Struthers does extremely well, not allowing Ingmafusi this time to get in behind her. The ball's played out into central midfield for Maddie Black to chase after. And that substitution now will take place. D'Souza will come in at right back. Battistella comes off from central midfield. Jodwan goes back into the middle for coach Alex McNutt and the Ravens. D'Souza does well. Plays the ball into LaVecchia. She lets it run for Nealon. Nealon trying to turn away from the Lakers' defence. The ball breaks to Ingmafusi. Ingmafusi tries to take a shot from all of 25 yards. Easily saved by goalkeeper Bem. A good ball played up for McLeod. McLeod can't win it though. Kayla Wood battling hard against a big striker. McLeod's looked very dangerous here this afternoon since she's come into play. She seems to be fighting for every ball, battling hard against the defenders at every turn. Defenders hate playing against those type of players. They'd rather have the fancy players that want to step out away from them, try and take them one-on-one. You can defend those. Someone that's just willing to run right through you, though, they don't like the physical side of the game. It makes it tough to play against. And she's battled very hard this afternoon. Ball runs into touch. Off of Natasha Struthers. And it will be D'Souza with the throw-in. 10 minutes to go here in this match this afternoon. Looks like number 25, Andrea Way. Well, we're not quite sure who's coming off. No substitution is going to be made here. I don't think McNutt realised. I don't think he really had a substitution in mind there. Yes, he was looking at possibly taking someone off, but he looked out there. He just put Lavecchia back on. Nealon only came back on about 15, 20 minutes ago. Way is pretty much an out-and-out striker. She may be asked, though, to play in a wide position. It will be Kimberly Tate with this free kick. Joe Dwan will get this cleared up for Lavecchia. Lavecchia, first touch, makes some space for herself to her left. Poirier can't deal with the bounce. Sam Nealon with the arm all over Poirier. An easy call for the official there as Nealon tried to climb high above Poirier with the right arm. The ball's played out now to Dermott. Dermott plays it too heavy down the right-hand side for Stubbart to chase after. And Andrea Way will now take off number 7, Kimberly Bilmer. I'm just trying to see. Ingmar Fussey looks like she will go back out wide left. Sam Nealon will come out wide right. And Andrea Way will be the striking partner for Sheila Lavecchia to finish this match out. 8.5 minutes to go. Carleton 3, Nipissing 2. OUA East women's soccer action this afternoon on SSMCanada.ca. McLeod doing well, battling hard there against Joe Dwan. The ball breaks now for Church, but Kayla Wood reads it. Not the best of balls again, though, by the Ravens' defence. Church now trying to play it forward. She's closed again. Terrific work by Kayla Wood. But the second ball is found by Nipissing once again. McLeod is in an offside position. And unfortunately for Nipissing, that attack breaks down. Well, Carleton with an opportunity this afternoon. Ingmar Fussey down the left-hand side, tries to get a shot in there, too high. And as you can see to the right, behind goalkeeper Bem, the Carleton Ravens men's squad warming up for the second match of a doubleheader this afternoon to kick off at 2:15 Eastern. The Nipissing men take on the Carleton Ravens men, coming off only their second loss of the season yesterday. Lavecchia now drives a ball into, well, goalkeeper Bem right through her hands. Didn't get her body behind it, tried to take it with the arm. And it will be a corner kick. Well, I started earlier on to say that 3 points this afternoon for the Ravens will give them 24. It will put them above Toronto for the time being. Toronto taking on Queens this afternoon as well, in a very big matchup between 2v3. That ball whipped into the 6-yard box. It looked like it came off a Laidlaw. And goalkeeper Bem has gone down. A collision, I'm not quite sure. I was watching the action in the 6-yard box. I didn't see what happened to the goalkeeper. She looks like she's okay. She's back up on her feet. And it will be another corner kick for Carleton. Laidlaw looks like she's coming off as she got smacked in the face with the ball. Aromba going back in. And unfortunately, number 21, who's had a good game, Amy Laidlaw, since she came in early in the second half, is now having to come off with blood streaming, it looks like, from her nose. Nealon once again to drive. A good corner to the back post. A great chance, Kayla Wood. A good header, a good save by goalkeeper Bem. A lovely corner kick driven across by Sam Nealon. Kayla Wood met it full force with the head. Directed it down. Lavecchia will be... Oh, she's onside there. It certainly looked like she was offside. The ball breaks now to Nealon. Good save by goalkeeper Bem off that header by Kayla Wood. Lovely header. And a good save by the goalkeeper. But once again, another corner kick for Carleton. Nealon again, a lovely ball whipped in. Terrific crosses here by Sam Nealon this afternoon, these last two that she's taken. Pretty sure she'll be targeted for corner kick duty in the future if she continues to throw in balls like that to allow your strikers and your defenders a chance to attack it in that danger area. Valerie Hamilton just hooking the ball up for Shilvecchia. Tate battling in central midfield. She loses possession. The ball goes to Way. Way again looked like she came back from an offside position. The ball goes to Bem. Bem drives it into central midfield. Ingma Fusi brings it under control. Good flip over the top of Stubbart, but it goes into touch. And we're inside 5 minutes now of this thoroughly entertaining match this afternoon in Carleton's favour of 3-2. Can Nipissing surge forward one last time to get this tying goal here this afternoon, or will the Ravens be able to clinch it with a fourth goal this afternoon? Sam Nealon tries to play it forward again for Way. Hamilton comes off her shin. It goes out for a throw-in on the far side for Nipissing. Well, in a game where both teams certainly deserve something out of this, each one of them have done enough to get some points this afternoon. Unfortunately for Coach Castiglione, they're on the outside looking in as the Ravens try to see this match out and pick up three very valuable points that could see them sitting in third place at the end of the day here. If Toronto are unable to get any points from Queens this afternoon, a good ball whipped into the back post. Oh, Ingma Fusi coming in. Drives through that from about 12 yards out, centre of goal. Right between the middle of the football goalposts. Druggett and Carlisle challenging for that. Carlisle again knocks it high. McLeod is onside, trying to chase after this down the right-hand channel. Looking for some support now as she tries to turn away from Nienkamp. It breaks on the right-hand side for Stubbart. Plays the ball into the 18-yard box. Hamilton hooks it clear. That will be offside against Confessor. McLeod, though, is onside. And that ball breaks off of Nienkamp for a throw-in. Sorry, not Confessor. That was a Aromba on that far side. She'd come back from an offside position, intelligently decided not to play the ball. Left it for McLeod. And we now have a Nipissing chance the other way. Church inside the 18-yard box. Did have some space. And Lavecchia caught in possession, though. And it now breaks on this side for Black. Black, though, caught in possession. Lavecchia with a chance to launch it all the way down now for Andrea Way to chase after against Poirier. Poirier can only put it into touch. And it will be a throw-in for Sam Nealon and the Ravens as we're inside the final minute of the 90. Probably going to be at least 2-3 minutes added on in injury time. The ball's played for Lavecchia. Lavecchia, well, it's a wayward ball. I'm not sure if it was a shot, a cross, a pass. Either way, it's made its way to Amanda Ingma Fusi. She tries to bring Diane Jodwan down the left channel. Can't find her, and it breaks now for Tate. Tate out wide to Stubbart. Stubbart launching it into McLeod, and Kayla Wood there once again. Reading the danger, getting there first, and Poirier, oh, almost caught possession by Way. Now plays it for Dermott. Good defensive play by the from the front there by Andrea Way. And Poirier once again will have to knock it into Tate in central midfield. Tate trying to move forward. And Engwafusi wins it. Jodwan now plays it over the top for Way to chase after. It's way too heavy. And she'll never get on the end of that. Stubbart back to Dermot. Dermot's not the best of balls, though. Jodwan's first touch is poor, and it's put into touch by Stubbart. And the Ravens now just taking their time. Looks like the referee has given 2 minutes of injury time to be added on. At least it looked like two, or it sounded like two. It could possibly be three. The ball's into Way. Way turns away. It breaks out now for Black down the middle. She's asking for too much time and gets caught in possession. Amanda Engwafusi just hooks the ball high up into the air for Sam Nealon to battle against her opposite number Struthers. D'Souza now quickly on this down the right-hand side. Sheila Vecchi, there's two red shirts inside the 18-yard box. Three now. The ball breaks to Andrea Way. Good defensive play by Carlisle. Good play. Good non-call by the official. Alex might not looking for a penalty kick, but it was all ball by Carlisle. Good play. There's a 3-on-2 break here for Nipissing. The Ravens very slow to get back. After Brianna D'Souza had counter-attacked down the right-hand side, it was 3-on-2 for Nipissing, and unfortunately Aromba just not able to get the ball across for Church or McLeod to chase after it. Valerie Hamilton, not the best of headers. Kayla Wood will knock it all the way back into the Nipissing half. Dermot trying to keep it in play. She does so. Nienkamp will let that run, and it will be off the Raven defender. This must be the last chance, the last push. Oh, it's bounced over D'Souza's head. A great chance for Black. Her pass is too heavy into Church. And goalkeeper Bedick. Good defending by the goalkeeper. Once again, seeing the danger coming off her goal line a good 10, 12 yards away. And with a chance to clear the lines once again. Andrea Way now against Poirier. The two of them colliding. Carlisle, good work out to Black. Black again, the first touch isn't the best. What's a slack ball by Struthers. Engwafusi now looking to play the ball wide for Nealon. It comes to Lavecchia instead. Lavecchia now looking inside. A ball driven to the back post. Oh, it's a bit too heavy for Way and Jodwan as they were coming into the danger area. Well, the ball was rolling there and the referee decides that he wants that taken again. Sense of urgency by Nipissing, but it may be too little too late for them here this afternoon. Draggett wins there. It's not the best of balls though, and it's Lavecchia now with a chance to go on the outside. Takes a shot. Oh, terrific effort. What a goal. A wonderful goal. She cut to the right of Struthers. And on 90 minutes, another two-goal hero this afternoon. Sheila Lavecchia, the ball absolutely flew off her right boot. And that well and truly has stamped 3 points in the bank for the Ravens this afternoon. She cut inside the defender, went outside, and then with the right foot, absolutely crashed the ball into the back of the net. Goalkeeper Bem with no chance. And that will be the last main action of the match this afternoon. Two goals by Amanda Engwafusi, two goals by Sheila Lavecchia has given the Ravens a 4-2 win here this afternoon. Our player of the game, Amanda Engwafusi, with two goals and two assists this afternoon, setting up both of the goals by Sheila Lavecchia. A thoroughly entertaining match this afternoon. Nipissing took a 1-0 lead after 30 minutes on a goal by Confessor. And at halftime, that was the score. Amanda Engwafusi on the 53rd minute made it 1-1. Sheila Lavecchia on the 63rd minute gave the Ravens a 2-1 lead. 3 minutes later, Number 25, McLeod, tied it up at 2. And in the 75th minute and the 90th minute, first thing with Fusi, then Lavecchia with absolutely wonderful goals this afternoon. And your final score, OUA East Women's Soccer Action here for SSN Canada. My name's Gordon Smith. Your final score is Carleton 4, Nipissing 2. Stay